cowards shy away, come to take the throne. To conquer world powers, bring Jacob home. I'm quarterbacking like Jake DeLone, like Mount Rushmore, I got a face of stone.
Back to the word of the Lord. Wait, you guys were in the Trump rally? Tell me, sis. How is it that you can support somebody that hates black people? I'm about to say, is it your white bunny over there, your cake crusader, your white fake chocolate? Is that what it is? She did it for the good credit, didn't you, sis? I know you did. First and foremost, I want to say, call Allah, but now Yahweh, Bahashem, Mashiach, Malak, Yahweh, Shah. We're the Hebrew Israelites. We come here week in and week out to tell you blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans to repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand, and y'all the Israelites that the Bible speaks of. And to the rest of y'all heathen, y'all already know what it is. What's going on? Yeah, we're recording something. Y'all want to come learn what we're recording real quick? You already talked to him? Okay, I'll pray. You get my fly? Okay, all praises. All right, hey, man, look that information up, brother. All right, man. What's going on, big bro? You said what? You'll be in it? Well, I asked if they wanted to learn what we're doing up here. Would you like to learn? You down? What's your ethnicity, man? That's if you're African-American. Okay. All praises. Do you have a religious belief?
Flip your mirror around.
Do you believe in a higher power?
He had the mirror reflecting the light that they shot.
Okay. So where are you at now? Okay. Do you have any questions about the Bible that perhaps a pastor never could answer, anything like that? Any apprehensions, concerns, misconceptions? Fair answer. So, now in the church they teach that Christ came for everybody, right? Okay. Watch this. Give me Matthew 1 and 1. You give me Matthew 15.
This is Matthew chapter 1, verse 1.
Book. I'm sorry. 1 and 25. 21.
Matthew chapter 1 and 21. And she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people.
Shall save his people. If someone's walking by, they say, hey, whose mirror is that? And I said, that's his. That means that is belonging to you and you alone, right? So it's saying his people. That means that denotes a specific people, right? Go on.
From their sins.
From their sins. That's something else that's a possessive. Say, whose car is that? Oh, that's theirs. That's not everybody's car. That belongs to a particular people. So he's went to a particular people to save them specifically from their sins, right? Now let's see who we came from. Give me that.
Matthew 15:24. But he answered and said, I am not sin.
So this is Christ speaking. He's saying, I am not sin.
But unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
Now, does that denote everybody, or is that a particular people? A particular people, right? You see what I'm saying? So he was born unto his particular people to save them. What you got?
This is the book of Matthew, chapter 2, verse 6. And thou, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are not the least among the princes of Judah. For out of thee shall come a governor.
Out of these places, these cities in Judea, in Israel,
Shall come a governor that shall rule my people, Israel.
Rule my people, Israel. These are all possessive pronouns, right? So he's not coming for everyone. He's coming for the Israelites. Now, let me ask you something real quick. How did the so-called African-American man come to this place called America? Do you know? The average African-American man. Slavery, right? Now, did we walk? Did we drive a car, take a plane? How we get here? By ships, right? Okay. What if I told you that was in the Bible, prophesied 3,000 years before it happened? What'd you say? It blow your mind, right? You never heard of this before, have you? Watch this. First, before you get that, I want you to give me Exodus 20 and 10. Okay, so I want you to start at 15 as well. he got almost.
Book of Exodus chapter 20, verse 2. I'm the Lord thy God, which have brought thee out of the land of Egypt.
Now, are you familiar with the story of Moses and the children of Israel in the land of Egypt? What do you know why Moses went to Egypt, or went back to Egypt, rather? So you know, let my people go? He went to Pharaoh and said, let my people go? So Moses went back to Egypt after fleeing to tell the Pharaoh to let his people go. They were slaves in Egypt. That's why they had the whole Exodus, part of the Red Sea, and they walked out. Are you familiar with this? Okay. Now, keep reading.
Out of the house of bondage.
Read it again.
Exodus 22, I'm the Lord thy God, which have brought thee out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage.
So it's likening Egypt into a house of bondage, right? The word Egypt comes from a Hebrew word, matazaria, meaning double straits, or you ever heard the phrase between a rock and a hard place? They're pretty much a place of affliction, right? Now, is captivity another term for bondage? If you're captive, are you bound? Right? Now, slavery, that's a captivity, right? So we were in bondage, right? Now watch this. Now give me that. Start at 15, just so we can get the context.
This is Deuteronomy 28:15. But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
So it's being written, if you don't listen to what God is telling you to do and keep the commandments, then curses will come upon you, right? Now let's see what the last curse is.
Verse 68, and the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt.
The Lord shall bring thee into Egypt. Again, Egypt meaning a type of bondage, right? Watch this.
Again with ships.
With ships. They didn't need a ship to go to and from Egypt to Israel. They walked. So it's telling you I'm gonna send you back to a place of bondage on a ship. Who went to a bondage on ship? So-called African Americans, right? Go on.
By the way, whereof I spake unto thee, thou shalt see it no more again.
Meaning you're not gonna see this type of bondage in the land of Egypt. It's talking about a new Egypt. Go on.
And there you shall be sold unto your enemies.
Now what happened when we got off them ships? For what? We were slaves, but before we got put to work as slaves, what happened? We get off the boat, we're walking. What's the next thing that happens? I mean, they did that all throughout the entire process, just to be honest with you. We were sold off auctioning box to the highest bidder, to different families. So what's your last name, if you don't mind me asking? Bailey. Guess what? The Bailey family was the highest bidder that bought you. You know what I'm saying? So we were sold to our enemies. Go on.
And there you shall be sold unto your enemies for bond men and bond women.
Slave man and slave woman.
And no man shall buy you.
Etymology of the word buy, it just means to redeem, in a sense, right? No one's been able to redeem us out of the situation. We're still being afflicted to this day, man. So this is something that's happened to, where's the sign? That right there was summed up in one paragraph. Why is that? 32.
Verse 32. Thy sons and thy daughters shall be given unto another people, and thine eyes shall look and fail with longing for them all the day long.
Wasn't our children given to different families, sold off? We couldn't do nothing about it. In the Bible. Give me 54.
Verse 54. So that the man that is tender among you and very delicate, his eyes shall be evil toward his brother.
You heard what happened with MO3 and Lil Boosie? Boosie just got shot just for being down here, man. It's speculated he got shot in the leg, all right? Either way, he got shot at. The point is, he got shot at, right? But there's plenty of black-on-black crime, right? Always. Instead of us actually having a dialogue like this, how many times you walk up the street, you get mugged for no reason? All the time. And it's mostly by what? Your own people, right? Read on.
Okay. It says, and toward the wife of his bosom, and toward the remnant of his children, which he shall leave.
Black on black crime, black on brown crime, domestic violence, child abuse, single parent households. In one verse. Okay, real quick. No problem. Now watch this. Just let me get one more verse. One more verse. If you allow me to. Who got a flyer? Flyer. Gideon, flyer. Oh, you got a flyer already? Okay, all praise. All right, he got a flyer. My bad. Watch this. Give me Deuteronomy 1 and 1. Now, these are things that are written to particular people, right? And watch this. Deuteronomy 1 and 1. Let's see who all these curses. Now, these curses happened to us, yes? Now, that was just, you know, that was just a light spread of what happened. But let's see who this was written to.
These be the words which Moses spake unto all Israel.
Who?
Israel.
To all Israel. But you say you're African American. But what we went through, we can see in the Bible. But this is written to who again?
All Israel.
You know why that is? That's right. That's absolutely right, brother. You're an Israelite. More than likely from the tribe of Judah, man. You see what I'm saying? No problem at all, Ken. Hey, check that information on that flyer. Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand, man. All right? All praises by Hashem and Mashiach Malak Yahushua, man. All right, hold that. Give me that back in Psalms 119 and 81. Give me that back in Jeremiah 8 and 12. Man. At least this brother listen, man. But a lot of y'all don't want to listen, man. Y'all will go follow, just like that sister, man. She went to go follow after her slave master, man. That's why she went to that man. You know how many Jakes I saw in this Trump parade earlier today? It was sickening. There was Issachar walking around with a Mexican flag and a Trump flag all at the same time. Absolutely ridiculous, man. Give me that. 18 and 12. Because that's the thing, man. Y'all are so hopeless, you don't even know what to do with yourself, man. You just toss yourself to and fro every wind of doctrine, and you flock to whoever look like they got power, man. And you support those who hate you. Why? Because it's your own evil thinking, man. You don't have the laws of the Most High God in your mind, therefore you follow your own evil thoughts. Go ahead.
Jeremiah 18 and 12. And they said, there is no hope.
There is what?
No hope.
That's how our people feel, man. They feel like there's no hope in the society. There's no hope in this world. So they go flock to whoever look like they got the power, and they're hopeful that they're going to help it, but it's not going to happen.
But we will walk after our own devices.
After your own devices, your own vain thoughts, man, your own ways, right?
And we will, everyone, do the imagination of his evil heart.
And that's what y'all going to do, man, because your mind is evil. The ways of the mind is absolute wickedness, man. You fall in your own mind, you're going to fall, man. You need to follow the ways of the Most High God, man. Who created the mind? Why not follow the man who created the mind? He know exactly how it works. That's why he gave his laws. How y'all doing today? Y'all got time to hear the word of God? Y'all don't want to hear the word of God today? Not at all? No one can say hello? Do Black Lives Matter?
Let's have.
No? All right. Hey, man. Hey, you still got to at least reach out and try, man. Give me that. And I mean, hey, you still got to ask.
Psalms 119 and 92. Psalms 119 and 81. My soul fainted for thy salvation.
Our souls are faint for salvation, man. This is an endurance race, man. We just going to get tired. So we going to feel a little faintness. Hey, what's going on? You want to hear the word of God? You said no? You said what now? You just walking? You don't want to walk to hear to hear about God? And what he can do for you? Are you walking with the Lord, though? So you don't want to hear the word of God, but you walking with the Lord? You're walking with Satan. That's who you're walking with right now. Go on.
But I hope in thy word. Mine eyes fail for thy word, saying, when wilt thou comfort me?
And that's what we have. Our people are looking for comfort. Look, the comfort you're going to find in these law, statutes, commandments, and faith in who the world is and cause Christ, and ultimately faith in Yahweh, man. We are fainting for salvation. We're wanting the salvation, man. That's why we come out here. We do the work. We want the salvation to come expeditiously, as the powerful officer says, man. We're waiting on it. That's why we come out here and we hope for this salvation. Salvation for us means destruction for the nation. What's going on? Doing all right? Would you like to hear the word of the Lord? No? Are you Asian?
You gotta know, like, the tribe.
Man, he got to go, like, he got to zip up his eyes, man. Read on. Hold on.
For I have become like a bottle in the smoke, yet do I not forget thy statutes.
Yet, even though we're in traverse times, we don't, the men of the Lord, the men and women who actually follow this law, statutes, commandments, and the ways of the Most High, we're not wavering. We're going through this tribulation, and yet we are not going to forget these statutes. Right? Go on.
How many are the days of thy servant? When wilt thou execute judgment on them that persecute me?
And we ask that, man. We're being persecuted every day, man. Y'all can walk through.
Thank you.
Yeah, she did. But what's it called? But read that again.
How many are the days of thy servant?
How many other days? How long have we come out and serve, man? Granted, we happy to come out here and do this every day if we could, man. But there's a question, how long are we going to do this? There are people who are not walking in the law, statutes, commandments. They just look at us and they laugh, man. It's like these niggas just doing it for no reason. They out here doing this in vanity. It's not vanity, man. So how long, Reed?
When wilt thou execute judgment?
When will the judgment be executed? It'll be executed when you niggas decide to get right, man. When the 144,000 and the one-third are sealed, man. That's when it's going to get sealed. You can't hide from the light, man. It's okay. Your spirit is going to turn red and your skin's going to boil, man. That's why. What's going on, bro? You doing all right? All right, bro. Read on.
The proud that dig pits for me, which are not after thy law.
See? And the prideful, they done dig pits for us, man. They devise ways for us to fall, man. They devise ways for us to fall and not keep the law, man. Because they don't keep the law. And those are the people,
Change the laws and times.
Exactly. And it's the ways of heathen. And are people following the ways of heathen, man? They fall after the ways of the heathen, and it's absolute madness. So we got our own people being coerced to do it, convincing our people to follow them as they follow the heathen. That's how the prideful do us, man. Read on.
All thy commandments are faithful. They persecute me wrongfully.
And we do our best to keep these commandments faithfully, and we get persecuted. What's going on, big bro? Would you like to hear the word of the Most High God? Why don't you want to hear the word of God, man? Do black lives matter? Do black lives matter, bro? You can hold up the black power fist, but you can't give your own brother 5 minutes, man. I don't remember this dude, man. If we don't have a peaceful dialogue, I don't. Oh, yeah. Okay. Oh, my God, man. Go on.
They persecute me wrongfully.
We get persecuted wrongfully for this, man. A nigga can rap about drilling on another nigga, man. You know what I'm saying? Selling drugs, this, that, and the third. It's okay for a so-called black and Hispanic man to go out and sell drugs on a corner, but it's not okay for a group of young men to come out and teach the word of God, man. We get persecuted wrongfully for this work, Reed.
Help thou me.
We asking for the help of the Most High, but we have to do the work to get the help, man. Reed.
They had almost consumed me upon earth.
Even though they're taking everything over, we not going to forsake the precepts of the Most High God, man. That's what we trying to tell you, blacks and Hispanics. Keep the precepts of the Most High God, man. Keep these laws, statutes, and commandments in the faith, man. But y'all don't want to do that. Y'all want to be a rebellious house. You got Ezekiel 2. Hold Ezekiel 2.
Quicken me after thy loving kindness.
Quicken, make us alive out of that loving kindness. That might be fine. I won't rebel you. We are made alive in this loving kindness. Because we were lucky enough to be woken up to the fact that we are the Israelites that the Bible speaks of. That's why we're trying to tell you stiff-necked, hard-hearted niggas, man. Read.
So shall I keep the testimony of thy mouth.
And we're going to keep the testimony that's uttered, man. What's that testimony? These laws, statutes, and commandments. We come out here and tell you the prophecies that are going to happen and have happened, man. That's what we come out to do and tell you wicked niggas, man. But y'all have a stiff neck and a hard heart, man. Understand that. You got it? Go ahead.
Yeah, this is Ezekiel chapter 2, verse 3. And he said unto me, Son of man, I send thee to the children of Israel, to a rebellious nation.
And that's what we come out to. We come out to a rebellious nation out here, man. Getting, it's in Jeremiah, backsliding children. Go on.
That have rebelled against me, they and their fathers.
They and their father, and that's why we went through what we went through, man. Y'all thought we went through slavery for no reason? No. It's because y'all are backsliding, rebellious, hard-hearted people, man. We're cryogenically frozen necks, and y'all don't want to get right, man. Your fathers did wrong, and y'all out here doing wrong. And we out here trying to tell you to get right, but you don't want to do it, man. And they can tell you to get right, y'all don't want to listen. A white man tell you to get right, all of a sudden you want to listen, man. We don't.
Verse 4, for they are imputed, oh no, that's a lot, and they and their fathers had transgressed against me, even to this very day.
Even to this day, man. November 2020, to this day, y'all rebellious against the Most High God, man. Y'all rebellious against his laws, his statutes, commandments. You persecute his prophets that come out here, and y'all don't know how to get right, man. All you know is wickedness and evil, really.
For they are impudent children and stiff-hearted.
Y'all impudent and stiff-hearted, man. Y'all just don't. What was the character from life? Can't get right? That's exactly how y'all are, man. Y'all just can't get right, man. Y'all can do wrong all day, but you can't get right.
He says, and for they are impudent children and stiff-hearted, I do send thee unto them.
And that's where we go. We go out to y'all, man. We go out to y'all stiff-headed, y'all hard-hearted people. What's going on, man? Viva Mexico, man. Hey, Americano is Israelitas. Somos la familia, somos Israelitas. Get that man a flyer, man. Give him a flyer.
Thou shalt say unto them, thus saith the Lord God.
And that's what we come out to do. We come out here and tell y'all, thus saith the Lord God. Thus say Abenawa Yahweh, man. Read.
Says, and they, whether they will hear or forbear.
Whether you're going to hear it or not, you're going to hear this word of Abinawa Yahweh Ba'ashem HaMashiach Malak Yahweh Shai, man. Understand that. Go on.
For they are a rebellious house.
And that's what y'all are. Y'all nothing but a rebellious house, man. Y'all want to do everything wrong, man. You want to walk in a damn Trump parade. You know, and damn well he don't like your ass. You know, and damn well he advocates for the locking up of Hispanics at the border, man. Literally during his 4-year tenure, there was a big separation of children from their parents of so-called Hispanic descent, man. But you want to walk in this man's parade. You got so-called black people, families, walking in there in that parade saying four more years, man. Why? Why do you love somebody that hates you? You not understand what that is? It's Stockholm Syndrome, where the captive loves the captor. What's going on? You got a question?
Come in. I agree with you.
You agree? Okay. You, do y'all believe in the Bible? Yeah. Most of it? What about Jesus Christ? You believe in him? Okay, can I ask you a question about Jesus Christ? Well, come on up. I don't want you straining your voice.
Come in.
She's mad at you? She will be. It's for her too. You have a terrible evening.
That's right.
You know. Ain't you supposed to be the man in your house? He got on shorts, she got on the pants. We know who ruled his relationship.
Then shall they know that there have been a prophet among them.
Y'all gonna know that there's gonna be a prophet among you in that day, man. When that calamity hits, and you're gonna be wondering, man, what was those guys on the corner saying? What was they teaching? What was they preaching? They was trying to tell me something. Where are they at? I can't find it. You ain't gonna be able to find us no more, man. You're not. We're not gonna be in these corners, man. There's gonna be a famine of the word coming. And then you're gonna know that there was a prophet among you in that day, and you should have listened with your hard-headed ass, man. Go on.
Verse 6, and thou, son of man, be not afraid of them.
We're not afraid of y'all, man. That's why we come out here and we tell y'all, thus saith the Lord, man. Whether y'all gonna hear it or not. Read.
Neither be afraid of their words, though briars and thorns be with thee, and though thou dwell amongst scorpions.
That's how y'all act, man. There are traps and wicked things coming after us, even though we trying to tell y'all, thus saith the Lord, man. Go on.
Be not afraid of their words, nor be dismayed at their look.
Y'all muggers all up and down. Y'all can even threaten us. Done pull guns out on us, man. Guess what? This word, this work still ain't gonna stop, man. You understand that? My father's business runs 25-8, man. Understand that? Read on.
Though they be a rebellious house.
Though y'all be a rebellious house, man. Read.
And thou shalt speak my words unto them, whether they will hear or whether they will forbear, for they are most rebellious.